What's going on, everybody? Teddy Baldassare from TeddyBaldassare.com. In this video, we're gonna be taking a closer look at a watch available for purchase on my website with the Timex Navi XL Automatic. So in this video, full in-depth review, and then at the end, kind of just unpacking with just some things to consider both on the positive end and the negative end of this piece if you are looking to purchase this watch. And again, TeddyBaldassare.com, full authorized dealer of all the brands that we're carrying, full factory warranty, very secure place to buy, very proud of our offering as well. So definitely go check it out if you are interested in this piece. I'll have a link to the product page down below. But guys, let's take a closer look at this watch.
Now first, looking at a rundown of the specs, we have a case size of 41 millimeters, thickness of 13.5 millimeters, lug width of 20 millimeters, lug to lug of 50.7 millimeters, water resistance of 100 meters, movement is an automatic Miyota 8215, crystal is mineral, and promo code first order at checkout if you're a first time customer of the store. Please use that promo code. You can get a discount off of this watch as well as other select brands on the site. Now with success with models like the Marlin, the Timex Q, it has been a very busy last couple of years from Timex in offering appealing pieces and upping the game in their mechanical watch offering. This considered, a watch that has really flown, I'd say more underneath the radar, is the newer Navi XL Automatics. Now this watch has some tough competition going in the range of sports watches for this price, but still, I think from a design perspective, this is a very appealing timepiece, similar to most Timex watches, an area where they typically excel. The version that we have here is black IP coated, but is also available in traditional stainless steel cases and different colorways as well. First, looking at this piece on the wrist, we have a watch with a decent presence of 41 millimeters in diameter, 13.5 millimeters in thickness, and a lug to lug of 50.7 millimeters. Now this watch wears pretty true to that diameter, if not slightly larger when factoring in the lug to lug distance, but still relatively manageable. In terms of a size recommendation, I would probably recommend sizing this for people around 16 centimeters, around 6.25 inches or 6.3 inches and up. Again, this really does come down to personal preference, but I just see this as a general guide for what some people might expect and maybe like. Now this case does come in a black IP coating, which is going to look a bit more tactical or stealthy compared to the typical stainless steel. This watch comes in a brushed matte style finish consistent across the case. Along the right side of the case of the three, we have a crown protected by crown guards. The crown operates in typical fashion as it is not screwed down though, but it does hand wind in the first position, changing the date at the second position, and then adjusting the time at the farthest out point. And this movement though does not hack, so it will not be able to stop that second hand in the process. A little bit more on that later. But even with this watch not being a screwed down crown, the Navi does manage to achieve 100 meters of water resistance, which is going to make it plenty capable of many water activities that you throw its way. Between the lugs here, we have the lug width that is 20 millimeters. The strap that this watch comes with is a simple black genuine leather strap with matching black hardware buckle at the end, tapering down to 18 millimeters. It is all right by Timex standards, I will say that, but I would definitely look at kind of spicing up this watch with a variety of different straps, maybe looking at some NATOs, some nylons, maybe looking at a rubber strap, as well as some different leathers to maybe dress it up. The strap features quick release bars on the outer side, so if you did want to kind of swap things out, definitely a nice easy way to do it. I do offer quick release bars to be added to any of the leather straps on the site for just $4 for each strap. So you could just follow up to the confirmation email that you get with your order and we can add those for you on your behalf. Jumping back to the center of the watch, we have a rotating bezel here. It comes in a reflective finish. It's 120 click and has a nice audible click, but does have some play when rotating. The crystal here is mineral and provides a clear view of the dial underneath while featuring a nice cyclops over the date window for just a little bit of extra magnification. Looking at the dial here, we have a simple white printed minute track along the outside, a date window at the three, and applied markers indicating each of the hours. The hands and the markers of this piece feature faux loom to create kind of that aged aesthetic, so I can see that being either a love it or hate it kind of feature. And similar to the other Timex watches featuring loom, it's going to be adequate for the price, but is not going to really compete with the likes of, say, like a Seiko or a Citizen, for example. Now, one very nice aspect of this piece is the inclusion of that military time or that additional 24-hour time along the inside of the larger hour markers. This also plays in with the handset, given that the hour hand here has a hollowed out indicator to reveal the hour within when it casts over this area. It's a pretty cool feature, and like basically any Timex watch, the design of the pieces are always probably the area where they separate the most and probably drive the most value, especially when looking at this entry level tier. Now flipping over the Navi, we have an open case back providing view of the Miyota 8215. Now, Miyota is a Japanese movement manufacturer and offers some of the better entry-level options from the mechanical watch point of view, and they currently fall underneath the Citizen Watch umbrella. The movement that we have here in the looks department is not going to really provide much, but in terms of affordable timekeeping, does definitely do the job. A couple points on this movement is that it is going to be rather noisy. You can feel the rotation of that rotor on the back of this watch. And then in addition, this movement is not going to hack. So in other words, when you do pull out that crown again to that farthest out position to adjust the time, the second hand is going to continue to tick. This movement's gonna operate at 21,600 vibrations per hour, 3 Hertz, features hand winding, has a 42 hour power reserve, and then out of the box, we're looking at minus 20 to plus 40 seconds a day. And this one, for some anecdotal evidence, is running at plus 20 seconds a day. Now, just to unpack here, to look at some of the positives and the negatives of this piece, I think, as always, we're getting some great looks with this watch, and that really comes to be expected with Timex. I think this piece, in terms of what it's going for, it's kind of got that dive watch look. It's got serviceable 100 meters of water resistance, so it is going to be adequate for the everyday. I think the big negative on this piece is just going to be, how does it stack up against the busy competition in this $200 price range? There is certainly some other places to look, with an Orient or a Seiko, for example. But when it comes to Timex, you're really going to do it for the design. I think the build construction of this piece is certainly better than a lot of their more entry-level options, say under $100. So it just kind of depends where your mind is at. The movement is serviceable. It definitely works. It's not great to look at, but most movements in this price range are not going to be that way anyway. So it really comes down to what you're going to value. Do you value just the best specs that you can get for the money under $300? If that's the case, I would look at a brand like Orient. But if you do care about more of the design, the style, and getting an adequate construction and a reliable movement, I think this Timex watch here definitely does the trick, and I think is a great addition again to this growing catalog of mechanical watches that Timex has been producing over the last few years.
All right, guys, thank you again so much for watching. If you did enjoy the video, thumbs up, subscribe, and hit the bell icon. Also, if you want more details about this watch, link in the description. TeddyBallistow.com, full authorized dealer of all the brands that we carry, also coming with a factory warranty as well. So guys, thank you again so much for watching. Be well, and I'll see you all very soon.